Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. In the comments section of an earlier video, a viewer raised a question in one of the comments that I thought would make for an interesting video. My laptop is a hybrid GPU, so for OpenGL, it is still using the integrated GPU, which is Intel. How do I make it to use the dedicated or discrete GPU, which is Radeon or NVIDIA? I've been trying fixing this for 2 hours now, but to no avail. Well, I'm sure we all know that feeling. In this video, I will show how to do this, first for linuxmint 22 and Ubuntu 24.04, and then later in the video for Fedora 40, including some tips and tricks along the way. This is a follow-up to the How to Configure On-Demand GPU Offloading on Linux with NVIDIA GeForce video. In that video, linked in the description below for your convenience, I have explained the same topic for NVIDIA. There will be the inevitable overlap between the two videos, but it might still be worth a watch to pick up on the generics. I won't be comparing differences between NVIDIA and AMD, because if you are just interested in one or the other, that might not be relevant to you. Open the menu and select Administration Driver Manager and wait for a few moments. In this case, there is no recommended driver proposed by Linux Mint. The open source AMD GPU driver is part of the Linux kernel, and there is a good chance that also for your card, no additional or proprietary drivers are needed. That is what Linux Mint is telling us here. There are no additional drivers needed. Now let's list the GPUs using the command lspci pipe grep vga. The onboard Intel video card is listed, as well as the AMD Radeon GPU. Note that I don't have a very fancy video card in my test system. I am just using an AMD Radeon 550. To check which GPU is showing as the primary renderer, type glxinfo-b. The OpenGL renderer is listed as Mesa Intel HD Graphics 4400. This is the onboard video card. Another check can be done with the command inxi-g to query about the system graphics information. The first device is the onboard video card and the second device is the AMD Radeon GPU. Note that the driver is listed as AMD GPU and that it is part of the kernel. The renderer at the bottom is once again listed as Intel. By default, the system is in an on-demand mode, meaning that if you want to offload graphics processing for a specific application or task to the secondary video card, you would need to specify this. Now let's see if the AMD GPU can render with the GL Mark II utility. GL Mark II is an OpenGL benchmark rendering test utility, and it is perfect to generate some load for the GPU. Type GL Mark II to start the rendering test. If on your system GL Mark II is not available, you can simply install it with the command sudo apt install GL Mark II. Every 10 seconds a new image will be rendered and you can see the results on screen. Check the GL vendor, GL renderer and GL version to check what GPU is being used for rendering. In this case it will be the onboard Intel video card. And we need to specifically forward GPU processing to the AMD GPU. Close the test. To now run GL Mark II on the AMD Radeon GPU, type DRI underscore prime equals 1 GL Mark II. Double check that the renderer is indeed AMD Radeon. This is how you can force a specific application to use the dedicated GPU. Just replace the application name in the command. Omitting the DRI prime prefix brings you back to the Intel GPU. If it is a desktop application and the application will support GPU offloading, just right-click it and select Run with dedicated GPU. To get some confirmation that the AMD GPU is indeed being used for graphics processing, there are a couple of methods. The first one is to install the ROCM system management interface. Sudo apt install ROCM-SMI and start the utility with the command ROCM-SMI. Here you can see many different aspects of your GPU. For starters, you could monitor the temperature, power consumption and fan speed to see if the GPU is being utilized. I will show more details of the ROCM-SMI utility and also a second, more graphical utility in the Ubuntu and Fedora sections. Both utilities are applicable to all of the three Linux distributions. Just like in Linux Mint, and this is not a surprise because Linux Mint is based on Ubuntu, the AMD GPU drivers are part of the base kernel. Let's check this by having a look at the Additional Drivers tab of Software and Updates. It reads that there are no additional drivers available or needed and that no proprietary drivers are in use. On the Ubuntu Software tab, the Community Maintained and Proprietary Drivers for Devices are both selected, but according to the additional driver section, we should be good to go. Run the same commands as before to check the GPUs in the system. LSPCI pipe grep VGA, glxinfo-b, and inxi-g. The default renderer is again the onboard Intel GPU, so the machine is in the on-demand GPU offloading state. For further details, refer back to the Linux Mint section of this video. When we run GL Mark II, it will use the integrated GPU by default. If on your system GL Mark II is not available, you can simply install it with the command sudo apt install GL Mark II. Offloading to the AMD Radeon GPU is once again done with the prefix DRI underscore prime equals 1. Double check that the renderer is AMD Radeon. This is how you can force a specific application to use the dedicated GPU. Just replace the application name in the command. Omitting the DRI prime prefix brings us back to the Intel GPU. If it is a desktop application and the application will support GPU offloading, just right-click it and select Launch using Discrete Graphics Card. Install and start ROCM-SMI in the same way as described in the Linux Mint section. Here I am showing the many different options available to you in the ROCM System Management Interface utility. Also, for Fedora, the AMD GPU drivers are part of the base kernel. Check once again with the commands shown in the Linux Mint and Ubuntu sections of this video. LSPCI pipe grep VGA, glxinfo-b, and inxi-g. The default renderer is again the onboard Intel GPU, so the machine is in the on-demand GPU offloading state. Note that the driver is listed as AMD GPU and that it is part of the kernel. For further details, refer back to the Linux Mint section of this video. Try again with GL Mark II. If it is not already installed, install it with the command sudo dnf install GL Mark II. When GL Mark II is started, the default renderer, in this case Intel, will be used. Prefix with the command DRI underscore prime equals 1 to enforce GPU offloading to the AMD Radeon. To do this from the desktop, right-click an application and select Launch using Discrete Graphics Card. Install ROCM-SMI with the command sudo dnf install ROCM-SMI. Once again, refer back to the Linux Mint and Ubuntu section for more information on how to use this utility. To have even more proof, install the utility Radeon Top with the command sudo dnf install radeontop. Let's start it with the command radeontop. This will establish a baseline, and as you can see, there is not too much happening. Start glmark2 in another tab with the DRI prime prefix and go back to radeontop to see the AMD Radeon GPU busy processing. Another indicator is the heightened power consumption in the ROCM-SMI utility. If it is a lengthier or heavy process, also watch the temperature and fan speeds for more indicators that the AMD Radeon GPU is being utilized. For all three distributions, as mentioned, AMD GPU is built in and available as part of the Linux kernel. This is the open source driver maintained by the Linux community with AMD's contributions. On AMD's website, the external proprietary driver named AMDGPU-Pro is available. This one is provided by AMD and includes proprietary components. It requires manual installation, but offers additional features and performance optimizations. It will depend on your specific use case if you need to use AMDGPU-Pro. For certain applications, especially professional and high-performance computing workloads, AMD GPU Pro can offer better performance and more features compared to the in-kernel driver. There is a link in the video description for your convenience. For general consumer use, however, the open source AMD GPU kernel driver is usually sufficient and offers good performance and stability with minimal maintenance. That's it. Hope it helped. And if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time. Bye.